My name is Tade Adekunle, the Vice Chairman of the Harvest for 2019, Harvest Committee for 2019. Today is our Harvest Day for the Catholic Church of the Good Shepherd. We are thanking the Lord for what He has done for us. We are thanking the Lord for protecting each and every one of us. And we are praying that we take control today, and this will be a successful harvest. We ask all this to Christ our Lord. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Welcome. I like your t-shirt.
I like your t-shirt.
I'll copy you next time. Money, welcome. Welcome, sir. Can this one still go there?
Oh,
Jesus. Are we cold? Glory, glory to Jesus. We can make it louder. Glory, glory to Jesus. Better. Today's our harvest. And we are all happy. Please let the joy continue. Please just a quick one. This brochure that I'm holding in my hands is just a minimum of 500 naira and above. Please do us well to buy one at least or more, because we have it in mind that we have to finish them and not return them to the printer. Thank you. God bless you.
Sisters in the Lord. Today is a happy day. Today is a day the Lord has made, and we will be happy and rejoice in it. Amen.
Amen.
Who is happy to be here today for this day of the Lord? Please do something for Jesus. Let not be adored, let not be glorified, both now and forevermore.
Amen.
We are gathered today, the day that we have agreed to gather together, agreed with the Lord and in the Lord, to be with Him and to walk in building His house, in building a place for Him to be in. Today He will never forget us. Today He will continue to be with us.
Amen.
And I pray that all the activities of today, that all the good works that we borrow today, we will put in today, all our good desires, that God is a great mercy and love, that He will bless, that He will accept, and that He will through them bless and enrich us all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So as we begin the Mass, we continue to put our mind, knowing that God has also come here seated waiting for us today, and He will lead us back to our homes with the great blessings through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess the Almighty God
to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I have sent the Virgin Mary, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Especially, we present to him the sources of today's harvest. As we have been planning for months, for a long time now, we pray that he grants success and good weather for us throughout today in this harvest. Almighty ever-living God, increase our faith, hope and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, the Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. The book of Sirach. The Lord is the judge, and with him is no partiality. He will not show partiality in the case of a poor man, and he will listen to the prayer of one who is wronged. He will not ignore the supplication of the fatherless, nor the widow when she pours out her story. He whose service is pleasing to the Lord will be accepted, and his prayer will reach to the clouds. The prayer of the humble pierces the clouds, and he will not be consoled until it reaches the Lord. He will not desist until the Most High visits him, and the judge executes favor. And the Lord will not delay, neither will he be patient with them. The word of the Lord.
And the Lord heard him.
Lord,
Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I am already on the point of being sacrificed. The time of my departure has come. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have loved his appearing. At my first defense, no one took my part. All deserted me. May he not be charged against them. For the Lord stood by me and gave me strength to proclaim the word freely, that all the Gentiles might hear it. So I was rescued from the lion's mouth. The Lord will rescue me from every evil and save me for his heavenly kingdom. To him be the glory forever and ever.
Amen.
The word of the Lord.
Parable to some who trusted in themselves that they were righteous and despised others. Two men went up into the temple to pray, one a Pharisee and the other a tax collector. The Pharisee stood and prayed thus with himself, God, I thank you that I am not like other men, extortioners, unjust, adulterers, or even like this tax collector. I fast twice a week. I give tithes of all that I get. But the tax collector, standing far off, would not even lift up his eyes to heaven, but beats his breast, saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. I tell you, this man went down to his house justified rather than the other. For everyone Who exalts himself will be humbled, but he who humbles himself will be exalted. The Gospel of the Lord. Holy Gospel, wipe away our sins.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Even Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Today, we have gathered in the name of the Lord as we have agreed and have been planning for a good number of times now. Today we've gathered for our harvest. Amen.
Amen.
Our reflection this morning will comprise of today's reading and also the harvest, which is what we have been planning and what we are doing today. Amen.
Amen.
And in the readings of today, we will now find embedded in the reflections as we are going to have it, especially towards the harvest. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And I want us, who is happy to do something for Jesus today, begin to do something for him now. Do something for Jesus. This one is for me. He deserves all that we are and all we have. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We must put in our mind, know that our lives is a gift from God. Our whole being, the world in which we are, all we are and have are gifts from Him, and we belong totally to Him. Then, that should remind us, one of the songs we sing, oh yes, in the presence of the Lord, I will do what?
In there
is joy, and what? Like a river, and I will in. And again, he went further. We return what you have given in what? Whatever you are giving to God is what? You are returning what has been given to you. Praise the Lord. There's many funny things that happens in our lives. We look at children, they do that, and when they do it, it will laugh. But unfortunately, most of times, we ourselves begin to do it. And when we do it, God does what? He laughs. How many of you parents here have given your son or your daughter, your baby, biscuit or sweet, and is eating it, and you ask the baby, give me, the baby will say no? How many of us? Raise your hand, don't be afraid. You give the baby biscuit, you borrow your money, take. He said, daddy, thank you. And he's eating, he said, come, come, give me small. He will say what? No. Yes, it happens. And this is what many a times I and you will do what? We do. And when we do them, the Most High do what? He laughs. I am the one that gave you. So I can connect to you and the whole thing. All you need to do, come, drag the child, collect the biscuit, he will cry. That's the end. He will beat you. And that is what happened between us and God. Most of the times we think, I decide what to give God. Sure, you decide. But don't forget, before you decide, He has given you that which you have. Praise the Lord. And something very important again, in God's giving to us, and in we giving to God, most of the times God tests us with things that are high, to know how much we can give Him, and in giving Him, He will give us back. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We focus, they will take a look at what happened between Jesus, the widow, I think one of our announcers mentioned it last time. The Gospel of Mark chapter 12 from 41 to 42. And the Gospel of Luke 21, 1 to 4. Jesus and the widow and the offering in the temple. They were coming to do what? To offer their gift. Are we together? Am I communicating?
Yes.
They were coming. Jesus sat and was watching as they do what? They give. The poor widow came in and gave how many coins? How much? Eh? I'm not hearing you, my people. And the way she gave, God just said what? This widow did what? Gave highest. But many came and gave bunches of money. Why? Because she came from what? From all she had. That merited her becoming the highest in giving. Now, another good example. What happened between Elijah and the widow? Praise the Lord. First Kings chapter 17, 1 to 6. Elijah and the widow in Zarephath. Today something is happening and we go on. And I want to let us know some things that we must put in mind. Jesus Christ today is said, at the name of Jesus, at the mention of his name, what will happen? And what? Every tongue that what? Jesus Christ is Lord. When was that said? When was he granted that? When was it that he, whenever his name is mentioned, every knee bows, every tongue confess? It was after he proved himself. He died. He gave up himself. He suffered and rose. Say, at the name of Jesus, even he was power. When God wants to do or to test you, he will not test you halfway. He will test you when you now prove, yes, I am faithful and believe in God and trust in him. Then he will not prove. Another example is Abraham and his what? Son Isaac. He said, give me your son. And that was the what? The what? The only son he had. Earlier, Jesus, God has promised him, I will make you fathers of all the nations. And now, the only one he was given, Isaac, he told him again, do what? Offer it to me. A high test. And today, Jesus is testing and going to test us. Abraham went forward and he was not moving with any sluggish movement or with double mind. He went fully and comfortably going to offer the son. God did not say, okay, since you started going, stop. When he got there, God did not say, since you have preached, I know that you are going to do it. God allowed him, he built altar. He tied the boy. He put him on the firewood. He raised the knife to do the last thing. He now say, I know you trust and believe in me. Do not go further. The widow between the happen that took place, or the incident that took place in the widow and Elijah in Zarephath, as we have it in 1 Kings chapter 17. The widow was having oil and what? And what? And flour. Now, what is the quantity of that flour and the oil? Eh? Very small. Now, God sent Elijah to the widow. Go to the widow in Zarephath, because there were no food in the town. Elijah got to this woman, saw her picking what? Firewood. Elijah said to her, come. The woman came, said, go and please help me get water. She went to get water. He called her back, come, when you are coming, bring me a morsel of what? Bread. Not like a loaf of bread. And the woman sincerely and gently told him, what I have is a very small measure of flour and oil. As a matter of fact, I am going to bake it with this firewood. And once I finish baking it, it's the last. And my hope is, when I bake it finish, I and my only son will eat. And when we finish it, we wait for what? We wait for death, because there is no more thing. So that is the last hope. Elijah said, go, as they are going to bake it, but bring first to me. Is it not crazy? Hello, somebody. Is Elijah okay? This is what some of us would say. This man is like, he drink some bese, or he drink some gogoro or gogoro. Is the last year my son will take and eat and die. He says, I should bring first to you. But Elijah said, go, bring first to me. For the oil will not dry and the flour will not go what? Will not finish. Do you think that God does not know that that woman, that is the last thing that she was having? God knows. But to prove his greatness, you must be put to test. The woman begged and they gave Elijah. Elijah ate. Then, and they go on. The scripture say what happened? Hello, somebody. The jar of oil never what? Died. And they never lacked flour. So because of the muscle he gave, in life, they never eat to die, but they eat to what? To live. Praise the Lord. That is test of giving. And the word God say, or speak through his prophets, do this, the obedient in it. God does not joke and forget his people. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Jesus will be sitting watching today what we are going to put in the treasury for the building of his house. Amen. Amen. You must know giving to God. Challenges goes with giving to God. And when you are able to surpass those challenges, the sky becomes your limit. Just like the widow. She never continued and said, I told you that is the last thing. So how can you say I should bring to you first? But she went on in obedience to the word of God. Praise the Lord. What can ask? How can one give up all he or she has? The widow came and gave all she had. This widow prepared the last thing and the first of all gave to the man of God, doing the will of God. It's a challenge. And when you trust, knowing that all I have is given to me, by the Lord. All I have is given to me by the Lord. When we have that in mind and in giving to him, knowing that he's the one that gave us even the life we have, you never run into danger. Amen. 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 And the reward that comes from such giving. Let us take a look. The story between Elijah and that woman. After Elijah ate and was going on, say after a little while, the son, the only son of that woman, what happened to that son? That son fell sick. And the sickness became intense till the child died. And when he died, the woman went to Elijah. Man of God, what have you done to me? Why did you come to remind God of my sin? That he has taken away my only son. Now I have no son again. Elijah took the body of the young boy up is where he was staying and made statements to God. He said, oh God, you read it, you take your Bible, when you get home, you take it, 1 Kings 17, read down. Elijah said, oh God, why will you allow this boy to die? Do not forget, this woman has been kind to me. She has been generous. She gave to me from that last she had. So please, she must not weep. She must not cry. She must be shown that she has done something good to God. So this child will be given back to her. And Elijah lay upon the boy, prayed and breathed upon him. The boy woke up and lived again. His life was restored. He was given back. That is, because of the goodness of the woman, because of her charity, because of her self-giving, even from the last that she was having. So there was no more going to die from food or going to die from sickness, but the good things she did brought them back to life. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We must note there are great importance and great reward from our generosity and goodness to our fellow human beings, and especially to God. Amen. In giving, there are levels. Nobody is too poor that he has nothing to give, and nobody is too rich that he don't have any need anything again. But in your giving, you know what God has made you. So in your giving back to him, he expects you to give according to your level. And that is why that poor widow, she didn't give like the big man, but she came from her heart. Now we have come, you know, sometimes when we come to church, especially in harvest like this, to give, to build a church, is actually trying to get more. Because the more you give, the more what? You receive. The more you give, the more you receive. So that is what happened. Why? Still in 2 Corinthians, when you read down from 9, chapter 9, from 6 to 15, the people of God, the people we are ignorant, then we are begging, please give us chance to be among those to be able to offer for the good of our brothers, the Christian community. That would be, we have a share in offering and giving for the name and the sake of God. So in coming to give God, you are actually coming to sow, to reap back. Givers never lack. Praise the Lord. Psalm 112, verse 5. So when you give, or when you are giving, become sacrifice, it continues to go well with you. When you are giving, you are giving in, you know you are sacrificing. When you are giving and sacrificing, it will pain you. It will take something out of you. You will feel the giving out. You are sacrificing something. Then it doesn't stop going well with you. Praise the Lord. Today is the day we have gathered to give to the Lord who has given us. And he knows us. I remember what happened many years ago when I was still in the seminary. The first time I entered aeroplane. Praise the Lord. The first time I entered aeroplane, because my life has been many a times when God wants to teach me some things, that will be a little thing that will show. I'll begin to follow it. At the end, he will not say, this is what I'm communicating to you. As a seminarian, the first time I entered a plane from Lagos to Calabar, the plane left or flew, were moving. Now I was looking up. It was fortunate for me, I was sitting by the window side, so I could peep from the window. You know, first experience, oh boy, I enter plane today as a young boy in the seminary, those early days. Not just I came to watch it in airport or touch it, but I entered. So I was eager, I was not looking out from the window of the plane. Now, vehicle, people passing as the plane was moving, and when it was landing, people passing, big lorry. They were like ants moving. Big river, like River Niger, was like a path road like this. Big city, I was looking, we look at it in the view. Yeah, I was wondering and looking at the whole thing. So this is River Niger, look at how small it is. This is vehicle, like ants. that at the end, the message came. If you, human being, just travel from Lagos to Calabar here, the plane did not go high, you know. You are seeing big river like a small path road, seeing the car like ant. How much more? Who is God? Who is up? That I see everything. That I see you even in your inner being. So sometimes we follow, we want to hide from God. He repeated this teaching also, showing me little ants. I was sitting watching ants carrying sugar and all these small things running. I know something was coming up. I continued to watch. They were going, moving, carrying things. When I do leg like this, what will happen? The ants will, they will scatter, not just scattering, some of them run into paper. Some run into small block or small piece of nylon. So the message, they were, as the voice came, now, this ant, they have hidden from you. Now, those ones that run into this paper, for them now, they are no longer visible to you, you can't see them. That's why they have hid. They are there, you can't see them. But what do I need to do? Just pick the paper up. Look at them. They begin to run again. Carry the block up. They begin to run again. So most of the time, you say, most of the times, we play prank. When you do, you think you are hiding. Do this to God. You think, I don't have it. Go for this. You say, I don't have it. What God needs to do is just do the paper like this. Do you like this. Or even use a stick. This what a broom. Take one broom. Lift the paper up. You see yourself that you are not covered. And that is at the end, he said, this is what happened to us. When we think we hide, we play God prank. When you say, come and work for me, you feel that I can't. But he has given you and he knows you and know everything he has given to you. So who exactly are you going to play prank on? On yourself or on God? So at those times, those ants, are they doing anything? Are they being protected from me? Are they covered? Are they secured? This happened to I and you. Today, God will be calling you to come and build for him. And he will be watching to see when you want to run under the paper and see that he will not see you, because you feel I don't have it, but you know they have it. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Luke chapter 7 verse 5. Say, you become a giver and lender. It goes well speaking for you. You become a giver and a lender. It goes well speaking for you. When we read further from that 7, from 1 to 10, it gives us a story about the Roman officer and his servant who was sick. The Roman officer sent words to Jesus that my servant is sick, please come and heal him. Those who went to Jesus said something, and that is where I'm coming in the gospel reading today. They went to Jesus and said, please, Lord, come and heal this man's son. They started counting for him. He said, this man is a good man. He built synagogue for us. He cares for the good of the people. He's a good man. Come and heal his son. And at that word, Jesus did what? Jesus left and followed them. And as Jesus was going, this man, having done all these things, he was still humble. He sent words. Please tell him that I am not worthy that he should come under my roof. The prayer you and I say today before communion, Lord, I'm not worthy that you should come under my roof, but only say a word, and my servant and your servant mine will live. The gospel reading, the Pharisee and the tax collector. The Pharisees keep the law, they observe the rule. The man is saying, I fast how many times a week? Eh? I give alms, I pay my tithes, I don't miss it. So I'm not like this man. In the giving today, we must give like this officer, Roman officer, not like the Pharisee.
God knows. And when you give in humility and simplicity from your heart, great things happen to you. But when Jesus heard the word, he said, tell him, I'm an officer, I have Romans, I have soldiers under me, I have servants, I have slaves, I command them, they follow. But I know I am still unworthy. Please, just say a word. My servant will live. And at that hour the man said that to Jesus. His servant did what? Lived. Don't forget, what moved Jesus? People began to speak for him where he was not. He built synagogue for us. Today, we are going to work to build the synagogue of God, build his house. And as people spoke, he deserved your blessings. He deserved his son to be healed. And that moved Jesus. So the good thing that come out from when we are generous and do and give, especially with good mind, God rewards it abundantly. Today, it will be a test. And in testing you, it will not be like a test you can easily pass. When you pass through a hard test, you go to a higher level. I mean, not be so. Today, that will be a great test. God is already testing us. So he'll be watching you. If you want to hide under small paper, like the ant, that he will still look and laugh. This ant, you are only under a paper. And I will lift the paper. You will be exposed. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
No one ever becomes poor from giving. Have you heard before that somebody, his bank account, his wealth, he crumbled because he was giving? I don't know if anybody has heard that before. Hello? Have you heard in history before that somebody became poor because he was giving? I don't know. Maybe I want to know today from somebody. Personally, I've been making inquiries. I've not seen, I've not known. Somebody who became poor because of giving. Have you heard anyone? No one becomes poor from his giving. Especially when you not give to God or for God's sake. Praise the Lord. 2 Corinthians 8:1-4, made this known. So giving is a response to God's grace. Giving is a response to God's grace. And in responding to God's grace, we connect ourselves to God. Giving is a response to God's grace. And in giving, we connect ourselves to God. One of the Eucharistic prayer made it clear. He said, our act of thanking you is itself your gift. Your act of giving God is the grace God has given to you. And St. Paul will say it, thy grace is enough for you. Do we allow the grace to manifest in us? The grace is in us to give him. So that it's just like to plant in his yard, that we will reap heavily. To expand our coast, to become bigger, to become richer. And that is implanting in his yard, implanting in him, that will multiply us. Note that divine things happen to us when we connect ourselves divinely. Divine things happen to us when we connect ourselves divinely. And in connecting ourselves divinely, we must respond to the grace. And the grace we respond to is, we must know that giving, which is a grace of God. And in responding to that giving, we connect ourselves. We must put that in mind. Knowing that God knows that today we'll gather to work in building a house. I said this last Sunday, I'll make it known again. The relationship between God and who? David. Hello, somebody. The relationship between God and who? David. David did many evil things, many bad things. But he said, in my life, I'm not saying yes, you continue to do bad things or whatever, but you must know
During Lent, there are three things that as a Christian or as a child of God we are expected to do. What are they? Fasting, prayer, and almsgiving, giving out. And the scripture made it known, say, God wipe away, he forgive, he puts away faults and sins of ours through our giving. And that was what happened to David. Despite the whole thing, David fought with his life to buy everything for building house for God. And God said, David is an apple of my eye. So don't even speak against David. Because when you do, you are speaking against what? An apple of God. The apple of God's eye. And the same thing today is an opportunity for us to have a share in building for God. I tell you, if you are in a parish that the church is completed, built and established, those who built that church, no matter how many years it has taken, you will continue to receive the grace of the prayer when you are there praying. I hope you know that. Whether you like it or not, there's no way, there's no truth about it. So sometimes it becomes a grace to be among those who we build. Because in building, you pour down your sweat and it's in that foundation. And it will not be blotted out till thy kingdom comes. As long as God lives and exists in that foundation, you will continually be remembered because it's part of your sweat and blood. So today, we are privileged to be among those who will build for God that will never be forgotten in life. I beg us, make good use of it. And knowing that when we work for Him, we are actually working for ourselves. When we are praying to God, is actually we are trying to bless ourselves. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You are blessing yourself first, sanctifying yourself. You are making yourself to be more holy and be what you're supposed to be, but calling the name of God. I pray that He help us today. That we will not hesitate in trying to do what He has inspired us to do for Him and in building His house. And in doing it with humility and simplicity in life. And I pray that He make our hearts ready, because sometimes we say it, the body, the heart or the soul is what? Willing, but the what? The body is weak. The weakness of the body today, you will think so, boy, if I give this one, what will happen to the next? The weakness of the body. You must know that in breaking through to a higher level, we must down what the flesh will pull you down to do. That is only what will lead you to the higher level. When you put God in a higher test, He will give you a higher proof. May God help us today to strengthen our hearts, that we will do even beyond what naturally we feel we could do. And again, sometimes when you want to give God, I've seen somebody, a man told me, he said, Father, something happened. I said, what is it? He said, I went to church. The priest was speaking about building the house of God, building the adoration ground for prayers. The priest came out and said, somebody who can help us give God, because it is a little primitive place, countryside. He said, what I mean countryside? That's village. So he said, somebody who can come and help us to give us 1 million naira in support of the building. People were like, this place? It's okay. One man said, he told me, he said, Father, I know I had that, I didn't have the money. I was not having 1 million with me. But I said, I will give 1 million, I will challenge God. And I was willing with my heart that once He give me, if I tell Him to give me that 1 million, He's coming back here and I know He will give me. He said He came out and promised that I will give God 1 million. I was not having it. And He said, once God prove Himself and gets the money, He will get it back. And within 2 to 3 months, how it happened, He will not know. He cannot tell. He got more than 1 million. And he went and submitted and said, this is what I pledge God. He has brought what to be given to Him. Just as I did between Abraham. He brings the lamb. But the thing, he must be ready and go forward to collect the lamb. That is by sacrificing. And when you are ready and give, then He will keep you. That one you have, keep it. Add this one.
May he help us.
Amen.
May he strengthen us.
Amen.
May he make us not just physically worthy of him, but also spiritually to be able to give in what he expects from us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Humble servant to whom he has entrusted the special grace of interceding for the world's salvation. Lord, have mercy.
And hear our prayers.
For those who work for the underprivileged, let their work, which will never cease, receive the support of government and peoples, so that through them, Christ's caring gospel may be preached. Lord, have mercy.
And hear our prayers.
For those in emotional difficulties, Let them call on the Lord, who is their refuge and help, to show them the path which leads to serenity and inner peace. Lord, have mercy.
And hear our prayers.
For those who feel too unworthy to pray. Let them, like the publican, beg the Lord's mercy and return to their homes, believing that He has heard and answered them. Lord, have mercy.
Demande à vous perpétuellement d'intercéder pour leurs associés, acheter le wedding fee à Cana, intercéder pour le couple wedding, tâcher pour leurs intercéder pour leurs, as you say, Hail Mary. Father, we make our prayers in the name of the Church, trusting not in our own goodness, but in your power to save, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Passion. He took the bread, did it thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will pour out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The blood of Jesus.
We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis our Pope, Martin our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who are fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may to be present in eternal life and be present glorified with you, your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the name of the Holy Spirit, all good and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
Christ who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of Christ's peace.
Thank you.
have to collect the blessings of the ten. So be it. Please come forward. Maybe what was meant for 10 we share to 30. Bless your hands. Father, King of Glory, I call upon you over these children, sons and daughters, who in faith has come forward in response to you, to give you. I beg you, Father, may they never go back unwanted. As I have called in trust to you, that you will do your wonders. Double that wonders over them. That they too will be surprised. Not just others, but they too will be surprised to say, even me, I didn't know how it happened. But joy, gladness will be in their mouths and lips and in their homes. And say, trusting the gift to you, that you, beyond their own imaginations, replenish them abundantly in the mighty name of Jesus. And I bless you. I bless your hands and your treasury that will be increased, enlarged by the Son and the Holy Spirit. May it be well with you.
Glory to Jesus. Glory, glory, glory to Jesus. I will just speak through some of the announcements before we do the harvest Thanksgiving. Please, we still encourage our parents, our mothers, our fathers to please let their children join the altar servants. We want to have more children to train to serve the Lord. Please do so. Harvest Bazaar will continue immediately after the final blessing. Please, we have enough to go around, food and drinks, entertainment to go around. However, we know this is a harvest period. Some will be free and some, just a token. Just a token. And it's very big. If I should call Sister Pipo here, we won't leave there so that I won't waste your time. But there are different dishes that they prepared. Place as they approach you, just a token, and it is given to you. If you order for 10, they will give you. Anyone, they will give you. It's also an opportunity to welcome new members who are worshiping with us today. It's an opportunity for you to stand up wherever you are so that our Father can pray for you. Please, if you are worshiping with us for the first time, please stand up so that the priest can pray for you.
In the name of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Father, King of Glory, I pray for these your children who for the first time are worshiping with us today and in this holy ground. Father, they have come today to witness you, to feel your presence. I pray over them, Father. You say, no one who comes to you will go back the same. As they
set their feet into this church today and took part in this highest sacrifice. May they not go back blessed. May they go back blessed. May they go back richly rewarded abundantly beyond their expectations. And they will have thoughts and reasons to continue to go and visit their house and worship together through Christ our Lord. And God, in His blessings be upon you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
As proper at 9, so you'll be welcome anytime. And God will bless you as you do so. Before we go to Harvest Thanksgiving once again, let me just finish the last announcement. And that is to call on the representative of the Unusual Praise Committee to briefly address us. Sister Toria, please, quickly come and address us, and then we'll do the rest.
Because we want the place to be very colorful this year. Sister Jane here is standing with me. She's the one in charge of your parish here. So from next Sunday, there will be a stand. Immediately after the Mass, you can actually approach, buy a t-shirt or support someone who cannot afford a t-shirt. And also, the unusual entrepreneur. I'm told to tell you, I'm sure you have some less privileged people here or some young people who are growing and actually want to be mentor. Two things, you can either be a mentor or you can actually approach someone you know needs help. And actually go on the website, download the form and also fill. But I'm sure Sister Jane here will also have some form by next week. So you fill the form, either to be a mentorship or an entrepreneur, someone who's trying to apply. Glory, glory to Jesus.
Just 7 groups, and in that group we even have the family coming
forward. It's funny on you today. Oh, 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 Come on, God, only your name that you are here. You have been with us this morning. Now we have entered the second part or session of the harvest of today. Father, come and be with us. Come and grant success to all that we are going to do. But at the end, we glorify your holy name. And as we glorify your holy name, you richly bless and grant us all we desire from you through Christ our Lord. And may the blessing of Almighty God be upon us all and over this program as we are having it. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace of God over you all.
Thank you very much, Father. So today, the program is not much at all. We won't waste too much of your time. The next I have on my list here is the chairman's speech. And while the chairman actually comes to give her speech, the colonels, we're going to be breaking colonels, then we're going to have the opening of the dish. But first of all, we really want to thank everyone that actually obeyed the call of Father this morning.
Round of applause!
And we appreciate all the men and women that actually obeyed Father's call this morning. May the good Lord of the heavens reward you all immensely through Christ our Lord. But for our keeping the purpose of the harvest, the Bazaar committee member would like to have their names. So at least we'll record all the names. For those who actually did the donation, be kind enough to kindly give your name to the committee here. That's the finance committee. They're just on my left-hand side. For everyone who actually came out in the different categories, please give your name so we can actually capture it properly. Thank you very much. So without further ado, I would like to call on the chairman, a chair lady today, no other person than Miss A.B. Paul Bennett. Can we put our hands together for her? Indeed, Jesus is our chairman for today, and he has done a great deal. Harvest of growth and abundance. Harvest of growth and abundance. We can see that God's hand is mightily upon us for this event. Because when we started, yes, there was supposed to be rain, but we prayed. God is an overcomer. We started this journey way back in June, July, and it's been fun all the way. Of course, like in every family, there will be ups and downs and arguments, but at the end, we all come back together as one family, and we have all come together to make this day a success. The purpose of our one house thing, the purpose of this habit, the proceeds from this harvest is going to go towards building our church. As we can see in the brochure, we have a story to tell. When we were driving down here, you would have seen red debris from our two structures that we are trying to put up as we were brought down. This time, we are standing and we are standing strong. We will not be put down again. Indeed, we will pull down this building of our own volition and erect our own church. So the money we are raising today, and I beg all of you to please dig deep, use your church mind, and step out in faith, and help us to achieve our aim. Let us build a befitting church for God. And I will thank you all again for attending, and I pray you all enjoy yourselves. There's so much to eat, so much to drink. A little bit of those will be at a minimum cost, but please, everything goes to the church. Thank you very much for coming, and have a wonderful time in the presence of God today. Thank you, our able chair. Can we appreciate one more time, please? Thanks.
Okay, good afternoon, everyone, and once again I welcome you to the Catholic Church of the Good Shepherd. We've gotten to the stage where these colonels need to be broken. We will need to take it to Big Daddy so that he breaks it and prays for us. And after that, we need to support him. You know, kola nuts could be very rascally. So when we break them, we need to support them so they don't roll over. Thank you very much.
Thank you. This is talking responsibility, right?
Brother, may I stand up? Hello, parishioners. I've been called upon to do the traditional thing. It doesn't come with gray hairs, because some of you have more gray hairs than I do. What I'm going to do is to break the kola nut. Traditionally, I should call the youngest man to carry it and ask individuals from various sections of the community to take one and break. Am I right? Am I right? The idea is that you support me, but let me keep my breaking amount to myself while I call on. Let me start with Anambra. Who is from Anambra here? Nlanugo. Nlanugo. Please, I need somebody from Anambra. Nnoli. You're from Anambra, aren't you? Please, stand up. Please, come and do the Anambra breaking for us. It doesn't matter whether you have elders, it's you that I know. Come and let him do it. I'm calling upon you to do the needful. Thank you. Take one for the matter of the other one, Amra, and go and consult and come back with a huge basket of money. While we are waiting for Amra, is anybody from Bayelsa? Anybody from Bayelsa? No, I'm waiting for you. Bayelsa, please. Let's do this quickly. Let us do Bayelsa River, Cross River. Okay.
Put in your mouth, still manage and praise the Lord. Praise the Lord!
Hallelujah!
Yes, good. Now we are going to cut the cake in the name of our God and Lord. And we will cut it through the name of the mother of our Lord. At the step of her name, we cut the cake. And I pray that through the cutting of the cake, that she will intercede to cut all the flaws of the evil ones upon our families.
Amen.
That she will intercede in cutting everything that is not godly in our lives.
Amen.
And as we cut the cake, through her name, that she will continue to intercede for us. She's the mother of perpetual help. She perpetually intercedes for her children. That she will perpetually intercede for us through the cutting of the cake. Amen. Amen. We go here or we go here? We live here. Alright. We will put our hands. We will get the case called. M.
M.
A.
A.
R.
R.
Y.
Okay, please, set your hand. Well, 1 second. Please, come, Ataga. Okay.
This one, conductor.
Eh?
Conductor.
And the count is Mary. M-A-R-Y. Mary. Thank you.
Thank you. You're welcome.
Pray over these children who have come supporting me in cutting up the cake.
Wise, for the collar, I will support with 200,000. But I will ensure that my overall harvest support is at least the 7 digits. The front and back digits, but I've just told you it will be 7 digits.
Yeah.
So let's start from there. And I think God will add more to that and bless this guy. Thank you all once again.
Your wife permission. You've gotten it. Amen. You dropped the cover already before. Yeah, we brought it to the table. We just announced the kid, my friend.
Okay, I'm going to break this cover
up with
about the
of our people of the church participated in this bazaar period and ceremony. That's an improvement, and that's the kind of community Mosito has been telling us that he wants to establish here, a family church where we do things, where we pray together and socialize together. On behalf of the Harvest Committee for 2019, we are indeed very grateful for your support
for your generous donation, for your time, and for all the things you have been doing since June. We know that there are pledges out
to Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May the Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Shout out the hands that are for the Lord.
DJ music, but low music to the very loud, I bet. Eh? New tempo.
Give up back to be men. Happy world, I'm ready to live. I'm about to rig in my mind.